أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
Second type of product is called vector product. This is also called cross product, like this one, this cross. Due to this cross, we call vector product as a cross product. Cross product is simply written as, for two vectors, let A cross B. Then if we want to multiply B with A, then we will join here B to A. That is equal to the resultant by right-hand rule. Right-hand rule is simply rotate the fingers from the direction of vector B to A. Then this is equal to BA. If we want to multiply A to B, then simply we will rotate the vector A into vector B. And the erected thumb will give you the direction of resultant like this one. Similarly, if we want to multiply B to A, then we will rotate, we will invert the right hand at downward and move from B to A. Then the erected thumb will be downward. That's why we take as minus n, because this is a vector product. That is, the resultant is again vector. That's why we write here the direction n. So simply this product is defined as, if the multiplication of two vectors gives a resultant vector that is alpha vector, then we call this as a vector product. So this is the explanation of the vector. Now we will write the example. For example, torque is a vector quantity. Torque is a cross product of moment arm and force. Simply vector multiplied by vector and resultant is again vector. So we call this as a vector product. Similarly, linear velocity is equal to V, is written as R cross omega, and angular momentum L is written as R cross P. These are few examples of vector products. There are other examples that can be described the vector product, and we will discuss later with the physical phenomena as well. Now the characteristics of vector product. I will try to compare the properties or characteristics of vector product with the scalar product, so that students may be able to understand both types of product. For example, in case of scalar product, first was the commutative and here is a non-commutative. If we want to take the vector product equal, then it is necessary to multiply any product with a negative vector. Then direction will alter and equal to same. Similarly, for parallel cases, that is two vectors having the same directions, theta will be 0 and sine 0 is equal to 0. And their unit product will also give the 0 resultant, because if we take two vectors along the x-axis, there are two unit vectors in along the x-axis, and we will write as I cross I, or in y direction j cross j, or z direction k cross k. For perpendicular vectors, theta is become 90 and sine 90 is equal to 1. Then the product of two vectors will give the maximum value. The interesting thing about the vector product is the perpendicular case about unit vectors. This is somewhat difficult as compared to the dot product, because here the resultant also have a direction. We will try to understand this one. Here I am going to draw a sketch to explain the convenient way for the product of unit vectors. Let's say this is the I unit vector, sorry. This is a cycle, and here we take I, and here we take J, and here we take a point K. from I to J, you will got the resultant K, like this one. And from J to K, from here to here, you will got the resultant equal to I. Or K to I, you will got the resultant J. Because scalar vector product is a non-commutative, so by altering the direction, the resultant will be equal to the negative sign. So this is the convenient way to learn about the resultant of two vectors. In the next section, we will discuss also about the multiplication of three vectors. Again, distributive properties, simple, A cross B plus C, that is equal to A cross B plus A cross C, or A plus B cross C is equal to A cross C plus B cross C. In the last, we will try to understand about the rectangular components. If a vector is resolved in three components, for example, vector A along x-axis as AXI, vector A along y-axis AYJ, and vector A along k-axis AZK, and B vector with the same three components, then the product can be found by manually also simply multiplication. But here we will prefer, the rectangular components multiplication by a determinant method, by first row, first column, and then first row, second column, and first row, third column. If we cancel the first row and first column, then simply multiply AY with BZ. I am here going to draw an arrow, this one, and minus this one. This is called cross multiplication. Similarly, for second, first row and second column, and we will multiply by this one with this one. So these are the three resultant with the multiplication of three components, and this is the resultant. In the last, the interesting property of the vector product that is different with the scalar product is the area of a parallelogram. Simply, the magnitude of A cross B, that is equal to area of parallelogram. So here, let's say this is vector A and this is vector B. The projection of vector A is here A sine theta, and projection of B is here B sine theta. Then we will label here, this is called, if I label here this one, this is called parallelogram. Hopefully you have understood this lecture, and please give your feedback, and best of luck. Allah Hafiz.